In this tutorial from the Oregon Health and Science University, we will learn the differences between articles that have gone through a peer review process versus articles in popular magazines or trade publications. Let's start by talking about what the peer review process is and why it's important. When an article is submitted to a peer-reviewed journal, a number of reviewers who are experts that are working in the same field as the author read the article and give feedback. The article may be rejected, it may be returned to the author with notes about how to improve it, or it may be accepted for publication in the journal. The reason this process is in place is to make sure that high-quality, accurate, professional articles are published in these journals. It's a crucial mechanism to maintain high standards of research and scholarship within a given field of study. Most academic journals, in their printed formats, have relatively boring-looking covers, and most don't contain advertisements or glossy pictures. The audience for these kinds of articles are usually going to be fellow academics, professionals, experts, and researchers, and the language and technical terminology in these journals reflect this. It should be said that the process of peer review does have some issues. Researchers and academics are often required to publish in order to advance in their professions. Some predatory journals take advantage of this requirement, charge these authors high fees to publish, and sometimes don't follow best practices in making sure of the accuracy of the articles that they disseminate. Additionally, there is more of an incentive to publish original research and scholarship. This can be problematic for the scientific process because it can discourage other authors from working to reproduce and verify previously published results. Even given these problems, the peer review process is the best mechanism that we have in place to uphold high standards of publishing in our respective fields of study. Popular magazines, while they do have editorial boards whose responsibility is to maintain the quality of what they publish, have no peer review process in place. These publications are often printed on glossy paper with colorful images and advertisements to catch the eye. The articles don't follow a standardized structure, and you will hardly ever see a bibliography at the end of them. Because the editors are trying to reach a broad, popular audience, the writing and vocabulary of these articles is tailored for non-expert readers. While you can certainly find useful information in popular magazines, you wouldn't want to use these as sources for your research or your clinical work. Evidence-based practice requires a much higher standard of research and information. There is one other category of print publication that should be mentioned here: trade publications. These are journals that are specific to a particular profession or field. This could include articles about businesses, technological developments, interviews with leaders, announcements about conferences, and any other news to help keep a professional up to date with real-world developments. They do not go through the same kind of scrutiny prior to publication that a peer-reviewed journal does, and they are also not written in a broad, accessible way that you are likely to find in a popular magazine. They live in a kind of gray area between these two kinds of publications. While they are written for professionals and experts, the articles in them are most often about developments in a specific field rather than original scholarship or research. It's important to understand the differences between these kinds of publications, as you will be asked to find peer-reviewed articles for your research during your schooling and beyond. There is one problem, though. When finding articles in databases, you'll notice that almost everything is just text. That means that you won't have the same visual clues that you would when looking at a print publication to tell you if it's peer-reviewed, trade, or popular. Fortunately, there are some other clues that you can use to figure this out. One thing that helps is that peer-reviewed articles mostly follow a similar format. They usually start with an abstract, followed by an introduction, and then sections on literature review, methods, results, limitations or discussion, and a conclusion. They will also usually have an extensive bibliography at the end. Here's a fairly standard example of a randomized control trial in a medical journal that has gone through the peer review process. Right away, you can see that it is written for other researchers by the terminology. This one has a brief introductory section, as well as sections on methods, results, discussion, and a conclusion. It ends with an extensive bibliography. If you see an article in this format or in a similar format that has most of these elements, it's a good guess that it has gone through the peer review process. If you still aren't sure about an article, the very best way to figure this out is to look up the publishing journal itself. Most journals will have an easily findable online site where, if they do have a peer review process, they will definitely want to make sure that you know it. You may need to navigate to an Instructions for Authors section or a Publication Process section to verify that they do indeed have that process in place. As always, if you have any questions about article types or any other research questions, please contact the library.